Welcome to the Modus world. Today we explore the story behind the Italian supercar powerhouse. Here are 10 things you didn't know about Ferrari. The badge is in honor of the World War I veteran. The Ferrari badge is instantly recognizable and features a black horse, rearing up on its hind legs over the letters S and F. This is not just a design that happened by happy accident, as each element of the design is symbolic and has a meaning. Francesco Baracca was a World War I pilot who was sadly killed in battle. The pilot would paint the symbol of the horse on the sides of the planes he flew. After his death, Ferrari met Baracca's mother and she requested Ferrari use the symbol of the horse on the badges of his cars. The letters S and F is an abbreviation of Scuderia Ferrari. When translated into English, this means the Ferrari Racing Stables. World War II delayed the launch of the first Ferrari. Ferrari began his racing career as a driver. In 1919 he quickly jumped over to Alfa Romeo, where he would be appointed head of the Alfa Course Racing Division. In 1939 he struck out on his own and began building race cars after agreeing to not use the name Ferrari for 4 years. In 1940, Enzo Ferrari produced 2,815 cars, but these weren't official Ferraris yet. Then World War II intervened, and Ferrari's factory in Maranello was bombed. In 1944 and again in 1945. After these setbacks, the first official Ferrari, the V12-125S, debuted in March 1947, 2 years after the war ended. The classic Ferrari red color wasn't the company's choice. Today's Ferraris come in colors ranging from bright yellow to soft metallic gray, but originally they were all red. That wasn't Enzo Ferrari's decision. Red was the color that the International Automobile Federation assigned to all Italian Grand Prix race cars in the early years of auto racing. And most people still overwhelmingly choose red as the color for their Ferrari. The color represents 45% of Ferraris sold. Ferrari doesn't make all their money from cars. Ferrari has been a highly successful company since the beginning and has made the majority of its money from the production. However, this is not the only source of revenue for this company. They also make a lot of money from selling Ferrari-related merchandise. This includes toys, clothing, accessories, and racing memorabilia. Across the world, there are approximately 30 Ferrari boutique stores. Only two of these belong to Ferrari, as the rest are franchises. Some of these stores have race car simulation games for customers to entertain themselves while shopping. You can customize every element of your Ferrari. Ferrari's tailor-made program allows buyers to personalize every component of their car. This bespoke experience happens at the Maranello factory, where buyers can choose everything from livery colors to interior trims, finishes, and accessories. Three collections are available: Scuderia, Racing Influence Selections; Classica, modern takes on the iconic Ferrari GT; and Inedita, innovative and out-of-the-box combinations. Once a buyer makes these choices, they can expect it to take up to 2 years to receive their car. Famous names like Eric Clapton have created their own custom-designed Ferraris. Enzo almost sold the company to Ford. Henry Ford loved cars and planned to dominate the automobile market. With the rise in popularity of Ferrari, Ford thought that owning the Italian manufacturer would cement his dominance in the automobile industry. Enzo and Henry reached an agreement, which Enzo backed out of before signing the sales papers. The deed angered Henry, who instructed his engineers to build a car that would beat Ferrari at the 24 hours of Le Mans. Ford's anger spawned the Ford GT40, which beat Ferrari at the race event. Ferrari angered Ferruccio, who established Lamborghini. Henry Ford wasn't the only auto engineer who had a bad taste in his mouth after dealing with Enzo. Ferruccio was another. Lamborghini was dissatisfied with the clutch of the Ferrari 250 GT that he owned. When Lamborghini confronted Enzo about the problem, the Ferrari owner responded, "Stick to making tractors, I'll stick to making cars." At the time, Lamborghini made tractors, but his encounter with Enzo prompted him to compete in the supercar market with Ferrari. The 1963 Ferrari 250 GTO is the world's most expensive vehicle. The best way to discover how much a vehicle is worth is by asking buyers. The way manufacturers do that is by auctioning their vehicles. When the 1963 Ferrari 250 GTO went on auction at the Pebble Beach in 2014, the highest bid for the car was $38.1 million. If you thought that was an exorbitant amount, then wait till you find out the price for the same car the previous year. According to Motorsport, an unidentified buyer took home the same model for $52 million. The 400th Ferrari Enzo went to the Pope. You don't have to be a Ferrari enthusiast to receive a Ferrari. All you have to do is become a prominent figure, as the Vatican found out in 2004. Ferrari had built 399 models of one of its most iconic cars called the Ferrari Enzo. The limited production run ended when Ferrari produced the 400th car, which it donated to the Pope. The Pope didn't drive it, but he did autograph it. The car was auctioned off at Sotheby's for proceeds went to charity, according to AutoWise. Enzo's last build was the F40. The F40 should be an iconic vehicle, considering that the car was the last vehicle that the brand's owner built. While that should be enough to make news, what made the F40 more iconic was that most car pundits considered it as the most aerodynamic car of its time. The irony is that during the production of the F40 he said, "Aerodynamics are for people who can't build engines." Some people thought Enzo was a bad person. Building a huge empire requires the entrepreneur to develop a thick skin. Some entrepreneurs become so shrewd in business that they forget to be nice to people. Enzo created a phenomenal car brand that will live for many years to come, but he didn't do it without stepping on a few toes. When Enzo's chief designer described his boss, he said about Enzo, "As a businessman, he is excellent. As a human being, he is a zero. Not a nice thing to say, but honesty is the best policy."